We have all heard the stories about COPD patients admitted to the ward with excessive oxygen, only to be found unconscious a few hours later. In this video, we will explore the true reasons why patients with COPD can develop carbon dioxide narcosis. It's clear that giving COPD patients too much oxygen can lead to elevated carbon dioxide levels in their blood. Contrary to what we've been taught, it's not mainly due to a suppressed hypoxic drive. Studies show that when we give these patients oxygen, their breathing slows down at first. But this slowdown only lasts for a few minutes, and then their breathing returns to normal. What's interesting is that even though they start breathing normally again, their carbon dioxide levels keep rising. So what's really happening? Two major mechanisms are at play here. The first is that oxygen therapy increases mismatch between ventilation and perfusion in the lungs. In COPD patients, certain lung areas are poorly ventilated because of emphysema or obstruction. This causes blood vessels there to constrict, so blood flow can be redirected to healthier regions of the lungs. This physiological process is known as hypoxic pulmonary vasoconstriction. When excessive oxygen is administered, it disrupts this mechanism, causing the previously constricted vessels to dilate. This in turn leads to increased blood flow to poorly ventilated lung areas, resulting in increased mismatch between ventilation and perfusion. As a consequence, carbon dioxide may not be effectively ventilated out. The second mechanism is called the Haldane effect. Deoxygenated hemoglobin binds carbon dioxide better, helping transport it to the lungs for exhalation. When we provide excessive oxygen, we increase the amount of oxygenated hemoglobin, which has a reduced ability to bind carbon dioxide. This results in an increase of free carbon dioxide in the blood. So, to sum it up, the main reasons for rising carbon dioxide levels in COPD patients with excessive oxygen therapy are increased VQ mismatch because of disrupted hypoxic pulmonary vasoconstriction and a decreased binding of carbon dioxide when oxygenated hemoglobin is increased. And remember, hypoxia should be your primary concern in COPD, so never withhold oxygen from severely hypoxic patients for fear of causing hypercapnic respiratory failure. Instead, titrate the oxygen to target an oxygen saturation between 88 to 92%. Studies have shown this decreases mortality and minimizes respiratory acidosis. If you enjoy this video, please like and subscribe.